saw the problems in the brick factories because nobody actually knew that there were mules and donkeys in the brick factories. So we started a project in 2009. We started talking about working on these issues, and we managed to get the donkey sanctuary on board. The main problems is initially when we started out, it was wounds and overloading and beatings, because basically the donkeys were handled by child workers, which is illegal, but that's how the whole system worked. But over the years, since we've been working, at least in the kilns that we're working in, we do workshops with the owners, with the handlers. We educate them about donkey welfare, their health. So I think things have really changed. The kind of wounds that you see now are much less than what we used to find. One of our main achievements, I would say, is that we managed to get a memorandum of understanding with the Ministry of Livestock. And we worked with them on coming out with a working animals directive. It's called the Animal Welfare Directive, but it actually addresses the issues of all working animals, whereby we've managed to state how many hours they should work, what they should be fed, how much they should be fed. They shouldn't be tethered, you know, things like that. And I'm also happy to say that we've managed to get animal abuse criminalized in the criminal code of Nepal.